The key to riding an avalanche train is preparation. I'm going to show you how throughout this virtual training series. These are proven effective techniques. I'll be sharing my 24 years of instructing experience in short segments that get right to the point. Now we're back in the studio to cover a subject that some have said takes two lifetimes to learn. Let's start with the basics. Answer to that is, it depends on the conditions. Your past history in the area isn't a good indicator of stability. The snowpack is different every single year. It's a different recipe. No two winters are the same. The snow is constantly changing throughout the winter. Check the avalanche forecast daily to see what's happening. Is the slope steep enough to slide? I use an inclinometer. Most people aren't good at guessing steepness, so what I do is I use an app. And here's one, Steve's Badass Avalanche Inclinometer.
48, 44, 39, 32, 26, locked to 22 degrees.
And what I can do is I can hold this, the bottom of the phone edge, up to a slope, and even from a distance, and get the measurement of the slope. So here's another app I use for an inclinometer. This app is free. It's a BCA app. I'll go to the measurement tools, changes colors with the steepness, tells you the aspect. Super easy to use and works really well. Once you practice with this, you'll become much better. You realize when you're in avalanche terrain. So where do you park in the backcountry? You want to park in a spot where you cannot trigger or get hit by an avalanche. This is called an island of safety or safe zone. You're very aware of your surroundings. You're looking around. When you stop, pick a good spot. Alpha angle tells you the maximum runout of the avalanche. It's around 20 degrees. It's farther back than you think. Don't park here, park here. Why? You don't have to move if it avalanches. You can keep an eye on the person riding the slope and get a better last seen point. Can't do this if you're running for your life. So park in a spot where you can get a good last seen point. By having a good last seen point of the person who got caught reduces the search area in most avalanches. I also look for signs of avalanches where I'm intending to park. I'm looking for trees that are broken, flag trees, trees missing their branches on an uphill side. Ridges are also a good spot to park. You're on the high point, avalanches break away from the ridge. Where not to park. Now let's move into situational awareness, being aware of what is happening around you and how it will affect you. Hard to survive if you're getting taken into trees, rocks, or off a cliff. Trauma is a big problem with avalanches. Think of where that avalanche will take you. Creek beds, V-shaped gullies, flat surfaces or depressions. The snow is not allowed to spread out and it piles up deeply. Here's where to be. Nice gradual runout where the debris has a chance to spread out. Can they trigger something that could hit you? You want to avoid multiple burials. Here's the problem. Rocks might be right underneath the surface and you can't see them. You may not even know where the thin spots are. Have to give yourself a wide margin of safety, especially with persistent weak layers and wind slabs. We're being very conservative in our terrain choices. Stopping and looking around gives you more insight to what's going on. You can miss valuable clues when moving at speed. I'm always looking for recent avalanches. The most observant rider tends to win. I'm going to give you a product tip now, how to put your radio in your pack. With the mic cord, I don't like to run outside of the pack. It can snag on branches and things like that. I'll run it through the shoulder strap. So the first thing I'll do here is I'll disconnect the mic cord from the base unit. I'm going to slide it through right here, the shoulder strap. Do not have it on the same side as your trigger handle. They're on opposite sides. Some people have made the mistake of grabbing the mic instead of the trigger handle. I like having the trigger handle on the right. I can grab the throttle, reach across with the left hand and grab the trigger handle. So it's going to feed up through here. I'll have to open the airbag compartment. So I pull back the Velcro. I get to the top part here and I'm just going to feed it through. Once it gets through the top, I pull it through. clip the mic so it's at a level so it's not bumping into your helmet. There's a little alligator clip here. Clip it there. And where this cord will go, you don't want to interfere with the airbag, so we go behind it, down into this right here. This has a dedicated pocket for the radio, otherwise it goes into the main compartment of the pack. Attach the mic to the base unit. Goes into the pocket. The advantage of this design is you can change your channels easily without going into the pack to get to the radio. Also, you can charge the radio while it's in the pack. Now let's get into more advanced route finding. Which avalanche problems are we dealing with and where are they? Which aspect are we on? Are remote triggers probable with the present avalanche problem? Is the weather contributing to the avalanche danger? How far are the avalanches running? If they're not running full path, you may be safe on the road at the bottom of the valley. Is the visibility allowing me to see clues? Did I look at maps ahead of time to see what's above me? Is this a good place to park? Lots of information to think about. That's part of the appeal of mountain riding. It's a thinking game. Don't just follow. Speak up if you don't agree. Hit the brakes. Let's put this into play. Here's a terrain route finding exercise that we'll go through. So we're going to do a route finding exercise. Trying to get from this green hut to the red hut. We don't have a lot of information. The goal of this is route finding, avoid common trigger points and places where avalanches may start. So common trigger points, convex rollovers. We're seeing which way the wind is going. You know, we have pillows of snow here, cornices, pillows down here. And the main thing we're looking at is, are we going to be on a 30 to 45 degree slope? This really isn't enough information. What I'd really want to know is what the avalanche forecast is and what avalanche problems we're dealing with. Because in this situation, I could be right down here on the flats. If this was a persistent weak layer, I could trigger the avalanche remotely from down here, so we wouldn't want to be here. But with the limited information we have, our goal is to get from the green hut to the red hut, staying out of avalanche terrain. Now, most people think, well, it has to be hot, it has to be a big slope. These little slopes can be a problem too, okay? So we pick our terrain carefully. We're looking to stay on ridges because on a ridge, the snow breaks away from it and we wanna stay off steeper terrain. So I'm gonna start here. I'm gonna tool around the meadow for a bit. Then I wanna get up higher. Before I hit this area, I'm gonna pick the right spot. I'm gonna go right up through here where it's a lower angle, okay? Now, if I had gone to either side of it, even right there, I triggered an avalanche. That's a 30 to 45 degree slope there. In this situation, I just caught the corner of it. You know, that could bury me in a small terrain trap like that. Your partners don't want to be on this hill at the same time. They're watching from back here, letting one at a time go. And that's a convex rollover. So I'm gonna go up this way, come on up, and then I'm gonna cut through here. Have to be real careful. I just triggered that slope, okay? And a steep slope like that, do you think it's gonna stop right there? No, it could take me into this terrain trap here. It's a depression. Here's another problem. Right up through here, okay? Now, why would I wanna go here? This is dangerous to climb. We have big pillows up here. It's definitely in the 30 to 45 degree steepness range, okay? So let's go over here. Gonna take a low angle approach up, coming up, and I'm gonna cut across. I wanna get to the hut. As I cut across, we enter into steeper terrain. One thing to think about is the consequences. If I trigger an avalanche here, where is it taking me? Into the rocks, it could run down here into this terrain trap here, a gully. So, before you just go shooting up a hill, pick some options. Measure slope angles, one at a time. Everybody else be parked well back, watching one person at a time. I'm gonna go up this way. It looks steep. I'm gonna pick a nice route, right up to there, to the hut. Okay? Watch what happens if I get a little too far right or left. Riding in this type of terrain, you have to be very knowledgeable. You have to pick your lines very carefully. A few feet one way or the other can spell disaster. We're gonna go down to another exercise here. So here's above tree line, and we're looking at slope angle. There's some steep slopes here, everything in the shade there, here, but all these little things too. We have to pick our lines carefully. Where are people going to park when they're watching? So I stop, I look around, it's like, you know, pretty good route would be here. I don't want to touch that. I don't want to touch that. I want to come right up through here, right up through here, and then across the ridge up to the top. Now, this is a huge cornice right here. Where does the mountain end? Where does the cornice start? It's right about there. So I have to be real careful. Let's give it a try. Watching my slope angle, coming up. I'm on the windward side, and then I cut to the ridge. Looks easy. Let's see if I get a little off course. What if the visibility was bad on this day? I couldn't see, we're up in the clouds. It's easy to make mistakes in those situations. You know, low visibility, we're coming up. Hit that. Coming up, watching it, picking very carefully where I want to go. Go up that way. What if I came down here? Try a different route. Really have to know your slope angle. Coming up, cutting across. There's many different options. Main thing we're looking at is slope angle. What's above us? You know, if this was a day with a persistent weak layer with remote triggers, we could trigger it here, we could trigger it here, we could trigger this whole thing from down here. You're getting collapsing here, collapses up the slope, and then you're in the runout zone for an avalanche. You're looking to see how far the avalanche has run. The higher consequence the terrain, the more knowledge you have to have. Next episode, we're heading out west. Check in to see where we end up. Here's some links to win prizes and learn more.